Good evening, everyone. Well, before you know it, skiing season will be here in the UP, and today was a sad day for the lovers of the Winter X Games. ESPN has eliminated ski and snowboard cross from the 2013 games in Aspen, Colorado. Iron River's Nick Baumgartner is an Olympian and winner of the 2011 Winter X Games snowboard cross title, and he's upset it's leaving. He wrote on his Facebook page today, "Let's get us back to put on an awesome show." The decision means that the costly X course, widely touted as the best cross course in the world each year, will not be built for the first time in the event's history. Snowboarder cross is one of the only three competitions that had made the schedule every year since the inauguration of the Winter X Games in 1997. Sad to see such a good snowboarder getting the axe from the worldwide leader in sports. So some local scores going around. High school tennis. West Iron County beat Ironwood and Hurley in straight sets 8-0. And then Kingsford beat Marquette 7-1 and Escanaba beat Gladstone 5-3. And then we also had some volleyball. Escanaba beat Manistique 5-3 in 5 sets. That also game happened in Manistique. Thursday is the opener for the NMU football season. At the University of Finland, freshman Ryan Morley will lead the offense this season. But what about senior quarterback Cody Suspaniak? He is the backup, and while many consider it a tough job to sit on the bench, he's embracing the role and becoming a leader in the locker room.
Ryan, you know, he's done a great job this camp. He's worked hard. You know, we both made mistakes, but, you know, I think we help each other and we work off each other's energy, you know, and I think he's going to be great for this team, you know, and I'll be right behind him, you know, rooting him on.
Well, Cody finished the 2011 campaign, completing 2 passes for 45 yards. He also made 7 carries for 23 yards and a touchdown against Tiffin. Look for him to bring some more leadership. And we go to the NMU volleyball team, entering its 39th season of competition in 2012. Looks like to keep their winning tradition alive. Today, the GLIAC coaches poll. NMU Wildcats were picked to finish 8th in the league with 152 votes. Ferris State University is predicted to win the title this season. They received 211 total votes and 10 first place votes. Tomorrow night, you can catch a glimpse of the Cats as they host the annual Green and Gold Intra-Squad match at 7 p.m. from Vandement Arena. And we go to the pros. The Green Bay Packers defense has a new pass rush in store, but the same playmakers as well. One of those superstars is Charles Woodson. He won Defensive Player of the Year in 2009, and the Packers look to take advantage of his versatility with the season only 2 weeks away.
It's a lot more valuable to us the closer he is to the ball because the different positions he can play, the number of different things that we're able to do with him.
The Pack Attack have their final preseason game as they welcome Kansas City Chiefs to Lambeau Field this Thursday. Catch all the coverage on TV6. And the Detroit Lions made a trade to bolster their defense. Washington Redskins cornerback Kevin Barnes says he's been traded to the Lions. Barnes was a third-round pick by the Redskins in 2009. He played in 29 games with 3 starts over 3 seasons, had 3 career interceptions. Sounds like 3's a company to me. Barnes was behind stars D'Angelo Hall and Josh Wilson on the Redskins depth chart. He was a contender for playing time as a nickelback during training camp, so more depth for the Lions. Make sure you go on UpperMichiganSource.com for more on that story in the Packers.
All right. Well, the Lions just need a healthy quarterback right now. I guess Matthew Stafford's hand is going to be okay.
Hand's going to be okay, but Kevin Smith said he wasn't okay, and Javad Best just went on the unable to perform list. So more running backs. They need running backs.
Yeah. And LeSure is still out, too, or he's going to be suspended for a couple of games.
Exactly. So.
Kind of thin at that position.
Very thin.
All right. Thanks, Donnie. Well, just ahead tonight, Fall Fest is welcoming students back to the NMU campus. The story coming up next.